Hello students, I have taken geography topic motion of the earth. Motion means movement of the earth. The earth has two types of motion. They are rotation and revolution. Rotation is the movement of the earth on its axis. The movement of the earth around the sun in a fixed path or orbit is called the revolution. The earth receives light from the sun. Due to the spherical shape of the earth, only half of it gets light from the sun experience day, while the other half away from the sun experience night. The circle that divides the day from night on the globe is called the circle of illumination. The earth takes about 24 hours to complete one rotation around its axis. The period of rotation is known as the earth day. The second motion of the earth around the sun in its orbit is called the revolution. It takes 365 1/4 days to revolve around the sun. We consider a year as consisting of 365 days only and ignore 6 hours for the sake of convenience. 6 hours saved every year and added to make one day over a span of 4 years. This surplus days added to the month of February. Thus, every fourth year, February is of 29 days instead of 28 days. Such a year with 366 days is called a leap year. Earth goes around the sun in an elliptical orbit. We notice that throughout its orbit, the earth is inclined in the same direction. A year is usually divided into summer, winter, spring, and autumn season. Season changes due to the change in the position of the earth around the sun. On 21st June, the northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. The rays of the sun fall directly on the Tropic of Cancer. As the result of these areas receive more heat, since a large portion of the northern hemisphere gets light from the sun, it is summer in this region of the north of the equator. The longest day and shortest night at these places occur on 21st June. At this time in the southern hemisphere, all these conditions are reversed. It is winter season there. The nights are longer than the days. This position of the earth is called the summer solstice. On 22nd December, the Tropic of Capricorn receives direct rays of the sun as the south pole is tilted towards it. As the sun rays falls vertically on the Tropic of Capricorn, a larger portion of the southern hemisphere gets light. Therefore, it is summer in the southern hemisphere and the reverse happens in the northern hemisphere with longer days and shorter nights. This position of the earth is called the winter solstice. On 21st March and 23rd direct September, direct rays of the sun falls on the equator. At this position, neither of the pole is tilted towards the sun, so the whole earth experiences equal days and equal nights. This is called an equinox. On 23rd September, it is autumn season in the northern hemisphere and the spring season in the southern hemisphere. The opposite in the case on 21st March, when it is spring in northern hemisphere and autumn in southern hemisphere. Thus, we find that there are days and nights are changes in the season because of the rotation and revolution of the earth respectively. Thank you.